Hello there, I'm Woolly Wormhead and everyone calls me Woolly. I'm a knit designer who specialises in hats. I have a keen interest in 3D, structure and technique and education, and that all comes into my work. I've been in this industry for 15 years. I have published over 350 patterns and 17 books, and I'm still not out of ideas yet. This is my first IGTV, and I'm coming here today to talk about the new website that we're working on. Over the years that I've been doing this work, I've always built my website myself, because I've never had the means to outsource it. But I don't have the capability to do that anymore. I don't have the skills, and I need to outsource it. The business is growing quite a bit and we need a much more functional, better website. Fortunately, I've been able to kind of save up over the last couple of years and get the money together to build this new website, and I am quite excited about it. What we're working on is focusing on accessibility. We've got a small army of us working together doing the prep work, and they're fantastic. We've got a lot of different skills that have come together, a lot of different experiences, and we're doing a lot of research between us and getting advice where we can and making sure that we're building a structure from the bottom up that's going to be adaptable and work how we want it to. And it is pretty exciting. It's a lot of work. We've been working on it, at least two of us. I've been working on it since, I don't know, July or August. And a couple of us have been on it a good few months. And we're slowly kind of coming in and building this all together and getting the information and getting all the data and prep needed. So I want to, before I start talking about some of the work that we have been doing, I want to let folks know, especially folks that have been following me for a while, that there is a delay to the website build. It's unfortunate and I'm sorry about it. And I know folks are going to be disappointed because a number of my customers aren't able to use some of the other websites that are where my patterns are for sale. Unfortunately, it's something that's out of our control. And it is still going ahead. It's not going to stop at all. We're just going to have a big delay. At the moment, I can't tell you how long that delay will be. We should have launched by now, but we haven't. But what I would do is I will keep you all posted via Instagram, via my newsletter to let you know how we're going. Hopefully by keeping you in the loop, you'll at least hopefully know when it's all happening and be aware of things that crop up as they do. Some of the work that we've been doing. I started in the summer working on all of the images to go with all of my patterns. This was one area that really needed a lot of tidying up. We do the photography ourselves, myself and my partner, and over the years the templates have changed or our editing skills have improved and they're not all been up to the same standard. One thing that I wanted to do, the first reason for doing all of this, was to put all of the photographs into the same size, to edit them so they all had the same proportions. The key reason for doing this is that when the images are presented on a website, if they have different proportions, the page can change as it flicks through the images. And this can be a problem for folks with photosensitivity seizure disorders. It can also be a problem for folks that might get distracted while looking at the website. It's aesthetically, it doesn't work very well either. So we wanted to make sure that the images are all regular so they would not cause any problems when viewing on the website. That meant an awful lot of editing for me. It was actually quite a good dive through my archives, if you like, and going through all the hard drives, because I actually found loads and loads of photos that have never been published, some of which maybe we didn't have the editing skills at the time to bring up to scratch, or maybe some of them I've just forgotten about since that happens sometimes. But what it means is that we've got loads of extra photographs on different models, in different lights, in different environments. Some of them are in different yarns completely. So that is actually something I'm quite excited about, is bringing these out, especially the ones that are in different models or in different yarns. There's, given that there's 350 patterns and 17 books, and there's anywhere between 4 and 10 photos of each, then that's thousands of photographs that have gone through and been edited. Fortunately, I'd done most of the editing in the past. Most of it was just kind of cropping and reframing, but there were some things that needed a bit more in depth. But that's all been done now. And I'm looking forward to launching those, because there's some really nice shots in there. The next thing that we've been working on, now that the photographs already, is working on the alt text to go with them. alt text, we have learned, is very subjective. There are also a lot of guidelines to follow if you want to make sure that your website is accessible. Alt text is also used for SEO. One of the challenges that we've, apart from the character count and making sure that the information is succinct, there's no point in overloading it. The alt text that's currently on my website is a bit of an overload because I wasn't aware of how that can work with accessibility concerns before, and I was just kind of putting all these words in for SEO, which is some of the advice that's often found. What we've been looking at, as well as reducing the character count and making sure that the information is relevant and correct in grammar and actually makes sense, is to think about how, what it is that we're, the alt text is for, to think about its context. What we've been looking at particularly is the product photos. Now, technically, the product is just the knitting pattern for a set weight yarn, a specific weight yarn. But people buy it because they want to make the hat. So the hat isn't the product, but it's part of the product. So we've been thinking about how we're communicating that actually this is a knitting pattern, but also that it's going to make this thing for a certain weight yarn, and this is what's in the photograph in a certain colour and a certain view. We wanted to make sure that it's informative, but again, as I say, not overloaded and that it's succinct. Another thing that we're going to be providing on the webpage and that we've been putting a lot of thought into is the descriptions. Most of us will be familiar that when we're looking for a knitting pattern, when we search around on websites or look on Etsy or Payhip, we will look at what we see as the romance text, which is the little bit of information that gives us some background to the name or what inspired the design. It's there to try and infer an atmosphere to kind of make you feel emotionally connected to it, really. That's what the romance text is for. But it doesn't really describe what the end product will look like. One of our team members kind of said to us that, you know, we can provide all this information, the technical information, we can do all these fantastic photographs, we can put all the information about gauge and all the search tags, but it's not going to help if the person who's looking at the webpage cannot see the photographs or isn't able to draw the information that we're trying to communicate out of the photographs. So we might have a whole range of photographs from different angles, but if they don't build a picture of what it looks like three-dimensionally, then that can also be a problem. Videos might solve that, but videos use a lot of bandwidth and not everybody has access to that. We don't have particularly good internet, so uploading videos is, you know, quite a problem for us. So we've started to work on a literal description of what the hat will look like, what its key design elements are, whether the pattern is a standalone motif and when it continues all the way around, whether it's a smooth or fitted crown or a gathered crown, what kind of proportions there is to it, what shape it is, what stitch patterns and what textures are like. So we're actually kind of not just describing the photographs, but we're describing the end hat, what you'll be getting, so that you have an idea of how that information works with all the other technical information, and you can decide whether it's something that you want to make. The descriptions are proving interesting. We are almost all written. We're just now working through and going through and checking the technical information and making sure that the grammar is correct and to make sure that everything is in there to describe it. This will then sit alongside the romance text that you will have two describing pieces of information about the item that's going to be going in. Another area that we've been working on is the search tags. This is something that actually is working concurrently while we work in all the other areas, because the information that we're developing is also going to be feeding into the search tags and using them and vice versa. The search tags are particularly important to make sure that the search function on the new website works. Currently on my current website, it's not particularly good. Unfortunately, I've not been able to do much about it because it's a feature, an inbuilt feature of the website builder I used. We want to make sure that you're able to search for patterns that have your specific needle size or your gauge or your yarn weight or your yarn type. You might be looking for a pattern of a certain shape or with a certain technique. You might want something that's worked bottom up in the round or top down, or something that's worked sideways. Even something that might be for variegated or handspun yarn. We're breaking all of this information down so that this information is there, that we can develop a more thorough and helpful search function, which is not as easy as it sounds, actually. It can be quite hard to kind of make, to kind of break down the tags in terms of how we think they might be used. We're getting advice on this and we're doing our own research as well. So we're breaking the data down so that if we find that as we're developing the website and it then goes into testing that maybe some of the features we've added isn't very helpful, the data that we have as it is now can be adapted and changed so that we can make it more of kind of future-proof and useful going forward. Other things that we're using the search tags with the search tags is a number of my patterns have been translated into a number of different languages. I want to make sure that they are easy to find, and also that when you search for them on the website, that those areas that are relevant on the website are also translated as well to go with the patterns. We're also developing a new pattern template for use with both screen readers and for low vision large print, so that we can then have that search tag on the website. That template isn't ready yet, but it's in progress, and we will then be able to start putting some of the patterns into layout and get them tested. So that's something that's coming forward, and we're also having more patterns translated as well. That's kind of an ongoing process that I'd like to do more of as well. So this is all kind of big part of the not just the search tags, but the information that we're providing on the website. Now, one of the problems with putting all this information together is to make sure that it's readable. You know, it's a very good thing to provide as much information as you can. However, if the way that the information and the text is provided is in large blocks or isn't broken up and presented well, that also ends up being a bit of an issue. I have severe ADHD, so I have trouble navigating large blocks of text or things that aren't laid out clearly or things that on the web page that might have a lot of distractions. So we're considering the layout and the presentation and also the navigation of the website, because these things are connected. The developer that we're working with, I said to her that we wanted it to be screen reader friendly and to also have a straightforward navigation, and she's found a system of working so that the information can be broken up, but also it can be navigated by keyboard at the same time. So you're only reading what you absolutely need to see at that point. Obviously, this is all going to be tested once we get to that stage in the website, but I'm quite excited about the fact that there is going to be a navigation system that will help make this information easier to find and easier to read, because we've got a lot of it that we're putting in. And that also is related to how the menus work on the website as well. We're going to keep a fairly straightforward navigation system. The colours and layout is going to be quite similar to what I have now, to make sure that the main menu always stays in the same place, so it's easier to remember where you've come to or where you need to go back to. Another area that's part of our concern that we're bringing into the website is hashtags. Hashtags have several uses, not least because you can connect with other projects on Instagram and see what other people are making, but also what we're going to be doing on the website is having a gallery for each of the patterns, and we're going to use the hashtags to pull that gallery primarily from Instagram. So it means that you will be able to go to the product page and see all the other patterns that have been made, see everybody's hats in different yarns on different people in different sizes with different adaptations, and I think that's going to be really, really cool. I will do a separate post and hopefully a separate video about what we're doing with the hashtags, because there's quite a lot that we want to cover with there. So keep an eye out for that. But that's really a summary of what we've been working on, which is quite a lot of stuff. I wanted to come here and give you a big kind of update, because we've been working away so heavily back end that it went a bit quiet for a while. And I want to keep you in the loop as much as we can. As soon as I have any information about when the website is ready to launch or whether we're going to be looking for testing, then I will, of course, let you know. But in the meantime, thanks for your patience and thanks for following along. And enjoy your hand knitting. And bye-bye for now. Bye. We are aware that there are different... that actually, we can provide all of this information. We can provide all...
I completely lost it.